Yes, people, what's going on, YouTubers? So it's been a minute since I dropped a video. I think the last one I dropped was about the ropes, where the ropes are landed. They are coming on 9 weeks old now. So yeah, they landed. Had 6 puppies, 4 come out ropes. We had 2, which are classed as standard females. Had 1 as bog standard, you know, standard Frenchie. And I had one that I would say that is a double of a rope structured without the rope. Yeah, we kept her back at the cobble. We'll do something further down the line. Got a few things going on there. So yeah, I'm gonna drop a picture of her actually, because she's absolutely tiny. I'll drop a picture of her. I'll drop a picture of her up on that, and then I'll show you the boys on a later video at the end. So yeah, basically, I'm talking about my experience within the rope. It's my first rope litter. I have another rope litter dropping next week. Or this week, the end of this week. So basically, it was my first rope litter. I wanted to go with the typical ropes, which is what I like. I use Pikachu. If you don't know about Pikachu, put him into YouTube or Google and you'll see him. So yeah, he carries a cream, a pied, a brindle and a blue. I put him with my girl that carries ATA, blue and Coco. Not for special, doesn't carry anything testable, anything like that. I just thought, you know, it's untouched waters of me. So I'd put it on this girl. And we had a bit of a rainbow litter, to be fair. It's the structures on these ropes. And there are different size structures. You'll see in a later video that I put up. But listen, there's a girl there that's amazing. She's not here, she's gone now. So I'll put a picture up of her. Her brother is just as much Marmite. The wrong point, listen. I'm just going to put it out there now. I think if you want to start and make a print in this breeding world, yeah, you need to start with a pied or brindle. You need to make sure that there's a structure behind there if you want to make your own path. Fair enough. If you buy in, you buy that dog that's got structure. Fair enough. But if you want to do it yourself, you start from the basics. Put your brindle in, put your pied in, and then you build and build and build on top of that. Personally, I've got nothing against brindles at all. I think there's some brindles that take your fancy, some brindles that don't. Same with the pied. All depends on the pattern on them that I prefer. So yeah, I've got some stunners in the litter, I'm not gonna lie. I've got little lab man, you'll see him in a minute. And I've got Marmite, Mr. Brindle. There's a blue and white boy that's available. Marmite, the Brindle one, to be fair, I'm struggling. I think he has to come in the right packet or it's gonna be a cobble. His structure, the definition of being a rope is this boy. You'll see him in a minute. So yeah, listen, everyone has their preference. That's my preference. You know, I have programs running behind, you know, behind closed doors, should we say. Yeah, things going on and hopefully it will all come together. But I'm in no rush. I'm in no rush to be DNA chasing this early into the game. I'm quite happy to put the structure in and then do the DNA. A lot of people say it's quite easy to put ropes into your program. Yeah, it is quite easy to put ropes in your program, but the right type of ropes, like it's quite easy to put, you know, colour into your program, but it's the right way around, you know, and doing it with the right background behind that dog. Listen, I'm just going to put it out there, like at the minute, I don't think a lot of these people that have got DNA dogs, Isabella, Fluffy Carriers, whatnot, you know, test all this, test all that. Listen, there's not a lot of people that have a stud or a female with mad structure. Handful of people that I can see at the moment that I follow. Listen, the one that's hitting it at the park at the minute is Junior Obeng. Don Frenchies. His propaganda is everything you want in a dog, mate. If you're looking for a little gorilla, that is it with all the DNA. Boys! That's puppy play for you. So yeah, that's that. Listen, there's no one close to that dog at the minute, I'll be honest with you. Even the fluffies that are coming through, they haven't got no big bow structure behind them. Yeah, don't be scared of the brindle in it. Don't be scared of the pied, the brindle, start your foundation. Yeah, it's just one of them, it's your preference. But me, I like that chunky French bulldog look. That's what I like. Don't get me wrong, I've got rat catchers, girls in there. It's the mum I've used on the rope, to be honest with you. And he said at the end of the day, I like them at the minute. I like them, and I'm not scared to be putting a brindle or pied dog on a dog to make sure you get the right structure. Because you'll tell you what, if you jump the queue, you'll be going back. Give yourself 2 years, but you've got the DNA, you'd be going back for structure. You know, start as you mean to go on. But listen, I'm going to show you the boys now. Yeah, so I think we know where we're heading. We know what we're doing. Like we've always said, we've got a DNA route and we've got a rope route. But our DNA is fully where the structure's at. We ain't chasing DNA. We have it. And we're now putting the structure in behind it that we've had going in the background the whole time, in all fairness, anyway. So, yeah. But we know where we're going. I'm going to show you a couple of ropes now. I'm going to show you a couple of them. Actually, I'm going to leave my phone here. And I'm going to go and get them. 1 second. I'm going to get them. So, here he is. This is your blue and white boy. The 10 points coming up. Obviously, we're pending DNA with him as well. Can you see how small he is? He's got a lot of skin to go into still, but not. You'll see the difference in a minute. So, here's his rope. If you can see him properly on there. He's a lovely, lovely boy. So, yeah, you can see he's the smaller side of stuff. But he's absolutely beautiful as well. He's one of the biggest in the litter and just kind of like stopped the way he is. So next boy. Right, before I show you him, I've told you all before, don't be scared of the brindle, right? Because they're big, the best things in your camp, right? Mate, this boy is amazing. Look at him. Look at him. The fur, the structure of this dog is absolutely insane. He's a beautiful boy. They are very chilled natured as well. But can you see him? He is short as well. But he's got all this. He's a lovely boy. So don't be scared of your brindle, innit? Like, don't be scared, because your best brindle here, mate, it's put nothing but structure. I'm struggling to let him go. But like you say, the brindle brings a lot of things. Your pied, your brindles, they bring a lot to the table. And this geezer here, you want rope in your program, mate. He's going to give you the best structure dogs you've ever seen. He's absolutely on point. So yeah, time being, I think your man's staying with me unless someone comes with the right packet and we're doing co-home, to be honest. I cannot let this structure slip through my hands. So yeah, let me show you Ant-Man and show you little Ant-Man. Yeah, so anybody that doesn't know Pikachu, who we've used, Google him and you'll see him. But this boy, there he is. Say hello, everybody. Say hello to everybody. This is Ant-Man. He's absolutely tiny compared to the rest. Actually, him and that blue boy are now kind of on pars. He is smaller still. But yeah, the blue boy is as small as him. You can see the difference with the brindle and with him. He's absolutely stunning. He's like a micro, like his dad. But he's a double of his dad as well. But there he is. Look at that man. It's our keeper. Our number one at the minute in the camp. But yeah, so you see the different size of ropes. So, like I said, this is only my first litter. I've got a lot to learn on the big ropes. And I'm excited to see what comes of them. So, yeah, I'll keep you all posted of what's what and how's going where. But we have another big rope litter dropping next Wednesday. So we're absolutely buzzing. So I'm going to drop in. As soon as they drop off, I'm going to drop in another video. And I'll probably show you them as pups, because a lot of people said you can't see straight away. I did straight away. I seen there was four. I seen there was three 100%. Within 2 days, there was four. And, you know, didn't drop off or whatnot. I'm going to put a picture up of the girl that went, because she's absolutely insane. Just as much as that brindle. What I will say on collar-wise you see it a lot more in this type of colour, the wrinkles. Marmite, which is the brindle, is just as much as these anti-sister, but because it's a brindle and it's darker, you don't get to see the full effect. But yeah, what can I say? Considering we put a rope and a standard Frenchie, I think we did good, didn't it, boy? Yeah. So next litter drops next Wednesday. I'm gonna show you them as pups, and then I'm gonna probably show you them probably at 6 weeks old. Is it 8 weeks? Nearly 9 weeks. I'm show them at 6 weeks old, and see what you think then. See if we compare the litters. Like I said, this is only my first litter. We compare the second litter, and we'll go from there. But listen, like, subscribe. Thank you for watching. Follow all my other socials. I'll drop a few pictures up after. Nice one. Is this